able to get accurate natural lights and accurate shadows according to the real geolocation of our project, we need to do some settings in Enscape and in Revit to be able to get that results that we are talking about. Okay, let's go to the Revit, and here we have some settings. The first one and one of the important ones is you need to go to the site menu, and here you have a point. I'm looking for project point. You need to specify the angle to north. It is really important for shadows because it's not the complete north like this. It has some deviation with the true north, and it should be like, for example, let me put it on 15 degrees. Now if I would wait a little bit, you can see the change in your building and in your lights too. Also, let me put the orientation views to the true north to see the difference. Now you can see the difference between these two ones. And also we have the suns here. We have some setting for sun in our Revit project that we have to do. You need to go to the sun setting here, turn it on, and from here click on, use the specified project location date and time, and then now you see it's changing now, but I'm going to pause the live update and then check, let's check the settings for our sun in our Revit project. Okay, let's go to the Enscape tab and pause the live updates here, and from here go to the sun setting. These are some options here that we don't want them because we are not going to analyze our shadows. I have a video about shadows, you can watch it on our channels, how to analyze our shadows in our Revit project. But today I'm just going to explain the sun setting. We need the still one, and from here you need to specify the location of your project. You have two options. The first one is to specify on the map. Here you need to specify it on the map, and also you can input your latitude and longitude here. But the better and accurate way is to get some numbers and get some coordination from your surveyors and go to the default city list, specify the city. For example, let me put it on Stuttgart, Germany, and then insert the latitude and longitude too, and then click on OK. And here, and also you can specify the time and date too. For example, I want the sun of October and also in day night. Also for the time, I'm going to put it on 12 p.m. or maybe 11 p.m. 11 a.m. and click on OK. Now you can see the difference here, and also you have some options in the Enscape too. Let's go to the visual setting here. We have some options that will affect on our sound here too. The first one is when you check the auto exposure, you can see the real intensity of your lights. But if you want to see the real exposure of your lights, you need to check it off, and also you can control the exposure manually here to make your scene brighter or darker. But let me reset this. You have also some other options in the sky part. You can, let me go to the atmosphere tab. We have some options here. We have sun brightness here. You can see the change of natural lights here. When you change it, it will be brighter or darker. Let me put it in a darker mode, and also We have some, we have another option here. Let me find it. In this sky tab, we have those parameters too. We have longitude and latitude, but don't change these. And let's Enscape rate the results that we have put it here. Let me change the options here to see the difference. Again, let me put it on another city, for example. Let me put it on, for example, maybe New York. Or for example, New Delhi. You can see the difference in latitude and longitude and click on OK and OK. And wait a little bit. Let me resume the live updates and see the updates here. You need to wait a little bit and you can see the change immediately. Okay, this is here. And also let me change the time of the day, for example, to maybe 9 a.m. Click on OK. You need to wait a little bit again to see the live results in your Enscape. Like, but we have a problem here. Let me show it to you. This is a problem here. For example, look at the sun here and look at the angles to the bill. Let me change the city again to see it will affect on that or not. It is just it just care about the time. And you put it on, for example, Maurice, or let me put it on Mexico City, for example, with different latitude and longitude. Click on OK and OK again and wait a little bit. Now you can see our sun position hasn't changed. So we can assume that Enscape doesn't care about the latitude and longitude of our sun in our rate, and it just care about the position, and also it cares about our time of the day. But how to change the angle of sun in our Enscape plug? Okay, so you need to go to the visual setting and from here go to the sky tab, and now you can change the latitude and longitude. You can see, let me show the sun to you here, and let me change the it doesn't change now because we have some options here. Let me change it from here, maybe. Let me put it on. Fifty, and click on OK, and now you can see the change here. Okay, so the results here tell us when you haven't specified the city and location in your Revit project, you can change the settings from a visual setting of Enscape. But when you have specified your location from here, you can change the settings in Enscape plugin doesn't affect on your sun. So you need to change them manually or with location in your